Have you ever wondered how researchers discover all the interesting stuff about space and time? Well, one of the devices they use is a particle accelerator, and it is what you think. Well, in general, a particle accelerator is a machine that uses electromagnetic fields to propel charged particles to very high speeds of energy and to contain them in well-defined beams. On a basic level, particle accelerators produce beams of charged particles that can be used for a variety of research purposes. Well, there are two basic types of particle accelerators. One is the linear accelerators, and one is circular accelerators. Linear accelerators propel particles along a linear or straight beam line. Linear accelerators are used for fixed target experiment. Meanwhile, the circular accelerators propel particles around a circular track. Circular accelerators can be used for both colliding beams and fixed target experiment. Particle accelerators are essential tools of discovery for particle and nuclear physics and for science that use X-rays and neutrons, a type of neutral subatomic particle. Particle physics are also called high energy physics and ask basic questions about universe. With particle accelerators as their primary scientific tools, particle physicists have achieved a profound understanding of the fundamental particles and physical laws that govern matter, energy, space and time. Now, let's see about the history and the usage of particle accelerators.
Inspired by a paper from Norwegian engineer Rolf Wildero, the earliest operational circular accelerator were cyclotrons, invented in 1929 by Ernest Lawrence at the University of California, Berkeley. Cyclotrons have a single pair of hollow D-shaped plates to accelerate the particles and a single large dipole magnet to bend their path into a circular orbit. The largest accelerator currently operating is the Large Hadron Collider, or LHC, near Geneva, Switzerland. It was operated by the CERN. It is a collider accelerator, which can accelerate two beams of proton to an energy of 6.5 teravolt and cause them to collide head-on, creating center of mass energy of 13 teravolt. Accelerators are also used as synchrotron-like sources for the study of condensed matter physics. There are currently more than 30,000 accelerators in operation around the world. Smaller particle accelerators are used in a wide variety of applications, including particle therapy for oncological purposes, radioisotope production for medical diagnostics, ion implanters for manufacture of semiconductors, and accelerator mass spectrometers for measurements of rare isotopes such as radiocarbon. There are two basic classes of accelerators: electrostatic and electrodynamic or electromagnetic accelerators. Electrostatic accelerators use static electric fields to accelerate particles. The most common type are the Cockcroft-Wellington generator and the Van de Graaff generator. A small-scale example of this class is the cathode ray tube in an ordinary old television set. The achievable kinetic energy for particles in this device is determined by the accelerating voltage, which is limited by electrical breakdown. Electromagnetic accelerators, on the other hand, use changing electromagnetic fields, either magnetic induction or oscillating radio frequency field, to accelerate particles. The common type are cyclotron and betatron. An example, a cyclotron was used to measure the radiocarbon. Since in these types, the particle can pass through the same accelerating field multiple times, the output energy is not limited by the strength of the accelerating field. This class, which was first developed in the 1920s, is the basis for most modern large-scale accelerators. In this video, we will explain specifically toward electromagnetic accelerators.
A particle accelerator works by using electric fields and magnetic fields. Electric fields are used to speed up and increase the energy of a beam of particles, while the magnetic fields focus and control the direction of the particles. This can be shown using Lorentz force law, which states that the force acting on a charged particle is due to electric and magnetic fields. It is shown by the equation F equals QE plus QVB. Based on the equation, only the force due to the electric field can accelerate the particles. The force due to the magnetic field cannot speed up or slow down the particles because it is perpendicular to the motion of particles. Instead, the force due to the magnetic field only changes the direction of motion of particles. The magnetic field produces centripetal force on the particles. This is what drives the particles to move in a uniform circular motion in a circular accelerator. As shown in the diagram, a negatively charged particle will follow a circular path of reduced rho in a clockwise direction when under a uniform magnetic field directed inwards. The components involved for a circular accelerator, such as a synchrotron, can be shown by this diagram. The particles are repeatedly propelled through a circular pipe. With each pass, the strength of the electric fields increases, accelerating the beam of particles. The particle source provides the particles, such as protons or electrons, that are to be accelerated. The beam of particles travels inside a vacuum in the metal beam pipe. The vacuum is crucial to maintaining an air and dust-free environment for the beam of particles to travel unobstructed. Electromagnets steer and focus the beam of particles while it travels through the vacuum tube. Electric fields spaced around the accelerator switch from positive to negative at a given frequency, creating radio waves that accelerate particles in bunches. Particles can be directed at a fixed target, such as a thin piece of metal foil, or two beams of particles can collide. Lastly, particle detectors record and reveal the particles and radiation that are produced by the collision between a beam of particles and the target. Over the years, the performance of particle accelerators has improved significantly. From the figures shown, you can see that the particle energy and center of mass energy generated over time has increased. The highest obtained energy is represented by the largest particle accelerator, which is the Large Hadron Collider. However, in the future, more particle accelerators will be developed with higher performance as well as more efficient.
Next is the limitations of particle accelerators. The first one is the geography. The largest accelerators and the fact that beyond physical and technical limits, there is a serious boundary conditions. The landscape. For a given technology, pushing the particle energy of a storage to a higher and a higher value will necessitate larger and larger machines, and we may suddenly encounter the problem that our device no longer fits the garage at our institute or not even in the entire region surrounding our facility. The second is voltage breakdown in DC accelerators. In general, these machines can reach higher voltage, but they are more limited in terms of particle intensity. Common to all DC accelerators is the limitation on the achievable beam energy due to high voltage breakdown effects or discharges. Without using an insulating gas, electric fields will be limited to about 1 megavolts per meter, and even with the most sophisticated devices, acceleration voltages on the order of megavolts cannot be overcome. Next is the size of the accelerating structure. For higher energies, even in the case of protons or ions, the speed will come at some point will approach the speed of light,
and the length of the drift tubes, and hence the dimensions of the whole accelerator will reach a size that may no longer be feasible. More advanced ideas are needed in order to keep the machine within reasonable dimensions. And the next natural step in the historical development was to introduce magnetic fields and bend the particle beam into a circle. Fourth is the magnetic guide field. The overall effect of the main bending or dipole magnets in the ring is to define a more or less circular path. This path has to be a closed loop, and so the main dipole magnets in the ring have to define a bending angle of exactly 2 pi overall. In addition to the main bending magnets that guide the beam onto a closed orbit, focusing fields are needed to keep the particles close together. In modern storage ring and light sources, the particles are kept in the machine for many hours, and a carefully designed focusing structure is needed to maintain the necessary beam size at a different location in the ring. Fifth is the Fizet Target Collider. The easiest way to perform physics experiment with particle accelerators is to bang the accelerator beam onto a target at rest and analyze the resulting events. However, the energy available in the system is not high enough to meet the demand for higher and higher energies in particle collisions. The design of modern high energy accelerators has naturally concentrated on the development of particle colliders, where two rotating beams are brought into collisions at one or several interaction points. The last one is the unavoidable particle detectors. Special care has to be taken when we wish to install a particle detector, especially when working at the energy frontier, just like the accelerators. These devices tend to expand considerably in size with the energies required. The storage ring has to be designed to provide the space needed for the detector hardware, and at the same time create the smallest achievable beam spots at the collision points, which is usually right in the center of the detector. The evolution of the particle accelerators had always occurred due to the limitations. For example, the evolution to overcome the limitation of voltage breakdown in DC accelerators was to substitute DC with AC. But with the use of the AC, the size of the accelerating structure was increased. Hence, the limitations was overcome by producing a circular accelerator. The evolution keeps going until today's accelerator and further in the future. In conclusion, electromagnetism is one of the fundamental forces of the universe, responsible for everything, from electric and magnetic fields to light. Electromagnetism is a very useful concept that gives us benefits in some fields. For example, due to electromagnetism, the particle accelerator play a big role in discovery for particle and physics nuclear, manufacturing of computer chips, and cargo inspection. So, electromagnetism is very crucial in scientific and technological applications of our daily life in the world.